That's actually what I wanted to ask you as well. How does that make sense that despite what is happening in the West Philippine Sea, the maritime situation there, that the PCG recruited foreign nationals to be part of their auxiliary service? How does that make sense? Does it make sense to you?
It doesn't make sense. It doesn't add up to Carmina. Imagine we're having some sort of a tricky issue between the boundaries of the Philippine government, the Philippine territory, and the Chinese claiming to be encroaching, or Chinese Coast Guard encroaching over the Philippine territory. So now, and then here comes the Coast Guard, who's supposed to be the frontliners in protecting the territorial boundaries of the country, suddenly recruiting from China, who's actually probably are just interested to look at what is the capability of the Philippine Coast Guard, maybe how many personnel does the Philippine Coast Guard have, or perhaps even the military equipment of the Coast Guard. Mm. So it doesn't make sense. I don't know. Is he saying that it's normal to recruit Chinese into the Philippine Coast Guard auxiliary? Mm.
But the PCG.
Maybe we should ask him also, Carmina.
Yeah, and
we plan. Ask him also. Mm-hmm.
And we plan to do that as well. But here's the thing, Congressman. The PCGA, it's a non-government entity, right, attached to the Philippine Coast Guard. But even so, should the recruitment process have been held in a vacuum, precisely because of the issues that you raised, Congressman?
Well, first and foremost, Carmina, as I said earlier, it doesn't make sense. Philippine Coast Guard. It's just Philippines. It doesn't say Philippine Chinese Coast Guard. So, alam mo, I don't know why he's saying that. Now, maybe we should look deeper into this. Because, I wouldn't want to be sleeping with the enemy, so to speak. No, while we're having this tricky issue in the West Philippine Sea, I will be recruiting people from their government to act as auxiliaries in the Philippine Coast Guard. Again, no, there's more questions than answers that they should probably let us know. Mm. Ano yung plano nila?
Mm-mm. I understand that there was an executive session sought. Nangyari na ho ba, Congressman?
No, not yet. Maybe we will call for an executive session soon, because this issue just came out when we were reviewing and we were deliberating on the modernization of our Philippine Coast Guard. Mm. Then suddenly this issue cropped up. And when we asked the commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard, well, he said that there were Chinese nationals who did not comply with the requirements to become auxiliaries of the Philippine Coast Guard that he actually delisted. Mm-hmm. So maybe we should ask Balilo if these people that were delisted found to be Chinese nationals were able to secure the required documents before they become auxiliaries of the Coast Guard. Mm-hmm. So again, no. Let me stress that it doesn't make sense recruiting people from China to become auxiliaries of our Philippine Coast Guard.
You know, Congressman, I remember very distinctly, it was one of the interviews that I had with one of the members of the Philippine Coast Guard, and they said during that time, and this happened in the last 2 years or so, that parang pag pumapalaot po sila, nandun na kaagad yung mga counterparts nila, or at least Chinese militia, na parang ang nabanggit dun sa interview na mukhang may abiso. Diba? Pagkatapos ngayon, meron naman pala silang membro ng sa auxiliary. Pero sila rin ang nagko-complain na may ganung nangyayari sa kanila because they're the frontliner. So again, to your point, it doesn't add up. But what is the end goal here? Because are you also wanting to find out who started this recruitment process anyway? Why was there a need to recruit non-Filipinos into the auxiliary service, Congressman?
Yes, indeed, we want to find out what was the reason why they started recruiting China or Chinese citizens to our Philippine Coast Guard. No, yes, you're correct. We also received information that our Coast Guard are complaining that every time they are going to deliver supplies to the Ayungin Shoal for our BRP Sierra Madre, they are surprised and being confronted by a Chinese Coast Guard in the area. So it's like, as you said, and appropriately said, merong abiso no, na nangyayari. And exactly the reason why we said that they're probably spying on us. And hindi yung depensahan natin yun. Dapat pag-imbestigahan natin, bakit nga ba ganun? Diba? It's not a simple just recruiting and, you know, they want to help. Yeah, right. That's a big no-no. They are Chinese citizens. They're not Filipino citizens. Mm.
And to the point that they said that they were already delisted, but Congressman, it took them 3 years to even delist. What does that tell you?
That's correct. Well, first of all, I'm glad that the commandant now, Commodore Gavan, took an action, an immediate action, when he found out that these people that were delisted are members of the Philippine Coast Guard Auxiliary that did not comply with the documentary requirements. You know? More importantly, they're not Filipino citizens. So there's no logic why the Philippine Coast Guard will recruit Chinese members, probably spies or probably militiamen of the Chinese government. So I don't know why they're trying to defend that. Some members of and officers of the Coast Guard are defending that. I don't know why. I don't know what benefit do they get when they recruit Chinese nationals, no, in the Philippine Coast Guard. Baka right. naman nga meron.
Ano kaya? Ano kaya?
Well, I don't know. I really don't have any idea, because in the first place, I wouldn't want to see auxiliary or Coast Guard auxiliaries that are not Filipinos. Eh, nangangailangan nga tayo ng mga Pilipino dyan sa area niyan. Eh, ba't natin lalagyan ng Chinese? Hindi ba? So, it doesn't make sense, really.
Add to the fact, I mean, it's at the very least, no? At the very least, Congressman, ang nakikita dito is that they use the PCGA to legitimize their stay here, at the very least.
Well, yes, yeah, maybe. No, I couldn't confirm that, Carmina, but perhaps that's one strategy to legitimize their stay in the Philippines. No, and mind you, I don't know what visa do these Chinese auxiliary members of the Philippine Coast Guard are when they entered the Philippines. So maybe we should check. No, and maybe the Coast Guard spokesman has an idea of who these people are. And first and foremost, we'd like to know why and when they started recruiting all these Chinamen, Chinamen in the Philippine Coast Guard Auxiliary.
And do you know for sure, Congressman, if the PCGA has been purged of these non-Filipino nationals?
Well, now that no less than the commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard made this announcement that he delisted and still, no, studying the others who are still in the list that did not comply with the requirements under the program of the auxiliary, the Philippine Coast Guard auxiliary, then I would want to give him the benefit of the doubt that they are really looking deeper into this.
And what are the possible sanctions for those who were responsible for doing this, Congressman?
Well, if we discover and we find out, at the very least, it would be treason. Although we are not at war, because treason can only be committed when there is war. But somehow, you know, I couldn't really tell you right now, Carmina, what possible violations they have committed. But one thing is for sure, there is a violation that was committed, or there was a violation.
And conversely, what could be a plausible explanation for why this is accept this is going to be acceptable? What could be a plausible explanation that they were going through their that was going through their minds that made it okay for them to do this? Meron ho ba?
Well, siguro, probably, no, somebody.
Or justification, justification to their minds.
You know, I'm. This is a puzzle to me, Carmina. I really don't know why they recruited Chinamen into the Philippine Coast Guard. While the issue between the Chinese government and the Philippine government is kind of controversial and tricky in that part of the country, the West Philippine Sea. Why are we recruiting them? We will be sleeping with our enemies, so to speak.
But still in all, Congressman, it happened. Obviously, there was a loophole. They took it, justified their actions. What loophole do you think is there, and how do you intend to plug it, Congressman?
In the we're presently deliberating, currently deliberating on the Philippine Coast Guard Modernization Bill, and perhaps we will scrutinize carefully how the Philippine Coast Guard and the auxiliary PCGA will be able to come up with a stringent regulation as to the recruitment of the auxiliary members. So maybe. Maybe we'll probably emphasize, you know, that we cannot recruit foreigners into the Philippine Coast Guard auxiliary. So I don't know if that's not very clear to those who recruited these Chinamen. But this time we will make sure that it's going to be clear and concise, so to speak.
I don't know. I don't know what's more ridiculous for me, Congressman, the fact that it happened and the fact that we have to talk about this, that it has to be explained. I mean, as you said, it doesn't make sense. But hopefully it will in the coming days. Please keep us posted. But in the meantime, I'd like to thank you for joining us today. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Carmina. And for my last words, maybe we should give them also the benefit of the doubt, as long as they can give us a justifiable reason when we do have our executive session. Then probably we will we'll bring it out in the open.
But what would be acceptable to you? Go ahead.
Well, if maybe, you know, maybe. It could be acceptable in the sense that these Chinese men who are businessmen in the country will probably donate equipment to the Philippine Coast Guard. But more than that, I don't know.
You're even laughing really, as you think about it.
It's still a big puzzle to me. I really don't know what gave them the idea to recruit Chinese or Chinese nationals to the auxiliary.
All right. As I said, keep us posted, Congressman. We're counting on you. Thanks again. Congressman Robert A. Barbers there joining us this noon. Really appreciate it.